Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am here with a very fun card tutorial. Today I am going to show you how you can easily make a Z fold card or a Z fold card. If you haven't tried any different card fold techniques before, then this one will be the best one to start off with. It is a very easy tutorial, but the results are really awesome. So let's go ahead and know how to make this easy fun fold card. For this card, I am using an A4 sheet and I am cutting down into half on the short edge. So my card will be measuring 11 inches by 5.5 inches. I will also be requiring another strip that measures 1 inches by 11 inches. So this is all you need to make this beautiful fun folded card. So what I'm doing is I'm taking this and then folding it along the long edge. Very easy tutorial. You can just do it even if you do not have any fancy supplies to make beautiful cards. All you have to do is cut a long strip. Here I'm taking a 5.5 inches by 11 inch card strip and I'm folding it into half. I'm just taking a blunt object and then creasing the fold so that when my card opens it has crisp folds on it. Now I am taking one half of it and again folding it to half. You can see it very clearly in the video here. I am again creasing it properly, making sure all my folds are creased well. So this is how my card opens and closes. I am cutting another strip of card that measures 1 inches by 11 inches. This will be additional. You can entirely skip this, but I thought this will enhance the scene that I am planning to create for my card today. I am repeating the same step that I have done it with the previous card piece. I am folding it in half first and then again folding one half of it into another half. I hope you can understand. The video is quite clear. So you will require a long strip that measures 1 inch by 11 inches. I am folding it in half, that is at 5.5 inches, and then again folding it into another half. So I will be, in case if you want to crease your cards, then you will be having to crease it at 2.75 inches, that is 2¾ of an inch and 5.5 inches. So I am just exchanging the longer pieces here. So the long piece of the 1 inch card piece will be coming and adhering here. So when my card opens, it looks like this. So this is a basic Z fold card. This is called a Z fold card because when you open it, it looks like a Z. So you can see here, it looks like an inverted Z or a mirror imaged Z here. So this is all you need to make your Z fold card. Just two pieces of cardstock, fold it in half and then again fold it into another half. For today's card, I'm using these beautiful images from Doodle Designs in Ink. I've printed them onto an A4 sized white cardstock. The advantage of digital images is that you can resize it according to the size you want and you can print it on either white or any colored cardstock. So here I've printed all the images. I will be using the other images on another card that I will be coming up in the next video. So for today I'm using this school bus or school van image for my card. As you can see here, I have cut out my pattern papers into size. I will be using them for the background. And the 1 inch strip, I have pasted black cardstock onto it. I wanted this to look like a road on which my school van will be going. So I've just pasted some black cardstock onto this 1 inch strip. So I will quickly go ahead and adhere all these pattern papers onto my base cardstock. This is a very, very easy card, and you can make them in multiples in just no time. Very easy to mass produce as well. So now I have heathered the pattern pieces on the base cardstock. Now I will be going ahead and sticking up this 1-inch strip of card that we have made. As you can see here, the long edge should be coming to the left of the card. Make sure that the short end of the base cardstock should match the long end of the strip that you have cut. This is a very, very simple card, nothing fancy and nothing difficult. You do not have any complicated measurements to make a card fold as well. Very simple card technique. All you have to do is take a card base, fold it in half and then into another half. And then for accentuating this card fold, I am taking another 1-inch strip of the same length as the base card and then again repeating the same folding. So as you can see here, first I have adhered the 1-inch strip onto the left side, and then I am peeling up the red tacky tape and adhering it onto the right side, making sure all my edges and corners are aligned well. So as you can see here, our base card is completely done. All you have to do is decorate it further with whatever embellishments you like according to the theme of your card. So as you can see here, I've printed this school van image onto white cardstock, colored it with watercolored pencils, and I have fussy cut it. I wanted to do a Teacher's Day card for my daughter's teachers since Teacher's Day is coming. So I thought this school van image will go very well with the Teacher's Day card. I've adhered my school van onto the black strip here. And to make it look like a road, I am taking a silver paint pen. You can do it with a white gel pen as well, or if you do not have a white gel pen, you can just do it with white paint. I am just drawing some white dotted lines here to make it look like a road on which my school van is going. I really liked how this card is turning up. So I will go ahead and write down some hand lettered quotes here. So as you can see here, this is my finished card. I've made some clouds on the background and I have written a hand lettered quote here that says, "Happy Teacher's Day and you're awesome." These clouds were made using a white gel pen. You can make it with watercolor or any other medium that you wish to like. These simple silver dotted lines has brought the card so much more interest. So here is one of my cards for Teacher's Day. So this is the gel pen that I have used to make the clouds. I hope you like this card and I was of some inspiration to you, and you will definitely try this fun fold card for your cards as well. Here are the close-up images of the finished card. I really liked how this simple card fold has brought in so much more interest to a regular card. Also, this fold is perfect to create scenes on the background as well. I hope you liked this card tutorial and you will definitely give this card fold a try. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope I was of some inspiration to you. Also, if you haven't done it yet, kindly consider subscribing to my channel. Also, do follow me on my social media where I share other card and craft photos with you. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.